I would like to discuss about commitment-driven failure for livelihood improvement. In my presentation, I divide in the introduction of our project, challenges and opportunities, and objective of the projects and milestones and lesson learned. Introduction. What is Gavidiriya? Gavidiriya is a community development and livelihood improvement project, adopts an innovative model of rural development built on principle of community-driven development. The project is implemented in the Gavidiriya Foundation, supported by the World Bank funded. The project aims at empowering rural communities and strengthening their institution to plan village development and manage resources by themselves. The SLS project basically empowers women and youth in the rural area. In the ICT infrastructure in the Gavidiriya project, even though there are so many ICT tools available in the Sri Lanka, most of the tools have not reached the rural areas due to various reasons, such as lack of infrastructure, high cost, language barriers, and absence of skills required to operate such ICT tools. In the Gavidiriya projects, we are designed basically in all empowerment of the beneficiary communities through direct financing, decision making power to community and giving information. In the community driven development approach, community is the owner of their development project. They plan their project, they implement and they monitor their development. So that the information is the key role to facilitate that Gavidiriya establish community information centers. Up to now there are 650 community information centers throughout the Sri Lanka. Community radio in Sri Lanka. You may heard there are community radio in Sri Lanka. Sometimes you may heard Kothmale Uwa, but they are not the real community radio station. Community radio means a community-driven radio planned, managed and owned by the community themselves isn't yet to be introduced in Sri Lanka. Frequency owner is the government and private sector. In the India, Nepal, Bangladesh, they have license issuing method in community, but in the Sri Lanka there is no such kind of situation. So that Gavidiriya project is started, that pilot project. Why Gavidiriya needs radio? In the Gavidiriya means strength of the village. Then people need they have to share their experience and they have to get other experience also. The radio is the cheapest model to reach community. So that the Gavidiriya project started this pilot project in the North Central Province in the province. To conduct this project, these are the changes and opportunities. Within the political acceptance for the another radio initiative, but completely driven by the community. Because the Sri Lanka is already, they have only government and private sector. We have to work hard to get this willingness. SLS poor communication infrastructure to ensure connectivity among poor communities. And the earlier stage community being aware about what is the community radio, then first we have to mobilize them to what is the real community radio. SLS is a community-driven development approach, continuous communication process is needed. Second one is address specific needs of such a geographical area that allow decision making on the use of production process technologies like that. Attract interest of communities and other stakeholders continuously and match demand with supply and high quality communication response. As well as in the community radio, the sustainability done by the community, they have to arrange some sustainability plan. The objective of this pilot project, the first, empower the rural communities to obtain a broadcasting license through Parliamentary Act, as well as provide required knowledge to have a sustainable community radio, promote rural livelihood and improve quality of life. As the third one is use the community radio as a catalyst of to socio-economic change through knowledge centers society. Provide education material and provide a platform for raising their burning issues, as well as use the radio as a translator to obtain world knowledge technologies through other forum or ICT tools in local context. And the project is basically for two phases, phase one and phase two. First phase of the project, we have completed mobilized community in the 27 villages. Mobilize more than 50,000 people around this concept. After that, we selected 27 core groups and we train them on this area. The five basic training were given. And they develop management structure and vision, mission, function of the responsibility and code of ethics of the radio, program guidelines and sustainable plan. After that, they are conducted experimental transmission by hired frequency. After completed this experimental transmission, community applied license. Still, they didn't get license because we have to work hard to get this license in Sri Lanka. In the second phase, we plan to obtain frequency for the community, then community radio station will begin. This is the management structure they have developed. In the every village, there is a communication committee. It consists of five members. After that, there is a general council. It consists 135, because each village has five members, then 27 in 135. In the area in Polonnaruwa, in the geographically, there were three zones. In these three zones, they selected 2 persons to they go to board of directors. In the board of directors, in the one manager, people's company directors and federation, these all community members. After that, in the general council, there is procurement committee, social audit committee, and finance committee. In the Gamitiriya project, especially, every committee should have 50% women participation and 30% youth participation. This is the model introduced the telecenter, because that with connectivity in the telecenter can get ICT education material, agriculture and healthcare information. In the rural area, the suitable is the radio station. They can disseminate this information. Milestone pass. Community could receive approval for their business plan and they complete training and work with political leaders to win their blessing, and they could work close with them, and they submitted application. During experimental transmission, the small survey was conducted. Sample size was 30. According to occupation, the listening, every farming, labors, business, and government, students, and others. It shows relatively listening is equally. According to age category, above 40 is the listening this broadcasting. Priority based listening, 23% listening the agriculture. They got information, their farming activities and marketing. When we ask what do you understand the community radio, the 22 is said that community radio is radio owned by the community, planned by the community and maintained by the community. And 6 said that it belongs to the community. And 2 said the program planning belongs to the community. In the lesson learned, empowered, mobilized and trained community can run community radio station successfully. Up to now they are narrowcasting and webcasting. You can get more information this communityradio.lk website, guidelines and everything. Thank you.